inside this program, you know, we, as I keep pointing out, the OSC has been really doing a very challenging task over the past, since its inception. I have to disclose that I was a BRSC scholar, you know, way back eons ago. So that's why I sort of have that special attachment to the OSC. But having said that, I also say that was also one of the reasons why I am in the NBI at least.
Yes.
I was the one who made noise about the NBI thing. Because when we were put on the DOST scholarship, believe it or not, we were all put on a NBI hot list.
And
immigration. At least the immigration, it has been settled after DOST gave me the clearance in 2004, years ago, working how many years in government. It was easy to get out of the immigration database. But with NBI, we were told, pag naipasok yung pangalan, hindi ho matanggal. How innovative. But that shows you, I mean, that alone is already another story altogether, you know? And until now, I think the solution of NEDA, the NEDA Scholarship Committee then was to just, from now on, no DOST scholars list will go to NBI. That was the, but I really made a lot of noise about it, partly because Don Padaranga was the one who asked me, give me a memo and I will do something about it. So anyway, that was the story about DOST. Now, set up, I think Francis has done some papers about set up, again, given all the resource constraints. There have been some successes, and there have also been, unfortunately, some problem areas here and there. And understandably, because once you invest in something you don't know, there are always risks. But that being said, indeed, going back to what Sheila was trying to say, that what exactly should we be doing? Unfortunately, this entire picture, much as we'd like to answer your specific questions on where to go, where to zoom in, we can't because the sample sizes are just not large enough to go. We wanted it to be very big enough. We were proposing to be 10,000 samples. But again, when we were proposing it, let me do a little bit of a story that we were told that we could not hire PSA as our data data partner because the budget would exceed the total budget of PIDS, etc., etc. So we had to secure permission from the GPBB.
Huh?
Yeah, correct. And then it took them a year, I think, when they still did not respond to us. For permission to hire PSA, that's why it took so long. And then by the time I said, we finally said, let's do it. How do we do it? So let's do the reverse. And what would be the maximum amount we could spend? And then bring down the sample sizes. That's unfortunately, we cannot answer your questions. It's as simple as that. But what can we do? I mean, not all answers can be learned from a survey. You can always do other data collection focused discussions within the specific industries. And you could get a sense of some specific areas. I know BOSP and BTI, for that matter, have been cooperating more. I give them a lot more credit that I think now there's been much more partnership between BOSP and BTI, believe it or not. In reality, you're right that most firms would probably think, if I'm a firm, I go to BTI. I really have to go to BOSP, unless they start saying, I have a site tech, I have a tech product that I want a little bit help on. Then, is there something that BOSP can give me? So that's why they start going to BOSP. And then when they start seeing, ay, ang dito naman budget, then, okay na kaya, they start going, you know, looking for other. Or they might be asked a little, then top up with other things. But fortunately or unfortunately, even if government has not been helpful enough to the private sector, there has been some innovation activity happening. Only thing is, it's been sporadic and unsystematic, and in a way, we could do better. That's the storyline. We could do much, much better. But let me give one specific example that being a data person, I've always been out for the championing of now the use of new sources of data, particularly big data, and I'm very glad that, you know, one university has, particularly the Asian Institute of Management, not that I'm promoting them now, but they've come a long ways, only because they had a dean, a woman, by the way, who is not Filipino, she's Korean, and she used to say, you know, when I was much younger, when I would think of Philippines, you would always think, wow, Philippines so far. But now, of course, you know where Korea is. And what did they do? They innovated. They built a knowledge economy. They had, here we have PIDS as one government think tank. They have many think tanks in various sectors. But I'm not even sure whether that's the right approach for us to do sectoral, because sometimes when we do sectoral approaches, I'm sure you might would agree with me, it doesn't work. Because when you start compartmentalizing, then you slice the pie rather than have a sense of what really needs to be done. But anyways, going back to AIM, what did Jikyong, the Dean Jikyong, do? It was Dato Balatao. I keep forgetting his full name. But anyways, he approached AIM and said, we should have a data science program. Of course, they didn't know AIM management, but why we need data science program. But they started initially, they were thinking of purely analytics, but then they focused on data science, especially with all this big data analytics. And the first persons that they started trying to hire were people, Filipinos, trained from UP, who left UP to work in A-STAR, Singapore. By the way, A-STAR, advancements for science, etc., technology. A-STAR, by the way, is a research institute that's not under the DOST equivalent of Singapore. It's under DTI, their DTI. They offer technology solutions to industry. They solve traffic, they look at so many things, systems approaches. And the two people there, no, who eventually they hired into AIM, physicists, okay, si Chris Monterola and Erica Rigara. Very good people, very bright people, who we lost to Singapore, but now we've got them back. Okay? And now they're into so many things. In fact, they're starting their own incubators of sorts of data science, and they're trying to do, focus on specific solutions. And we were just with them last week for a DTI meeting, and we were told that Acer gave them a supercomputer. The only one of its kind. It's a prototype. Maybe they're also trying to use them as a way to experiment. But anyways, my point here is that there are certain areas where we can focus on, but unfortunately, we're not quite leveraging the resources that we have properly. Part of it is because, going back to what we were showing earlier about the innovation paradox, there are missing complementarities. Human capacities. So even if we give DOST now all the money that it needs, that does solve the problem, because capacity needs to be built. And how do you build capacity? It takes a long time. Remember my point earlier about Deng Xiaoping, 1978, when he asked for 5,000 people to be given, to be Chinese students, to be sent overseas, remove all the barriers on language, etc., etc. It worked. Now they're all back, practically all are back. But us, where have we seriously made an effort to spend money on people to really bring them to the best schools? We will wait.
Because they don't get back.
Why don't they come back?
Because they're very competitive there. They can get...
Yeah, but then the Chinese were like that, the Koreans were like that. It's because we also are easy to... But the thing is, that's where your question to your answer about nationhood. We need to focus on that. Because I think we might be choosing the wrong people. Eh. Unfortunately, we need to also make sure that we know. He was the vice president of Mirabo. And he built the LRT, and he actually built the Bataan Nuclear Power Plant. Now, he was telling me that they trained a whole shipload of people to man the nuclear power plant. But of course, government decided to mothball the project. Fine. But what happened to these people?
Where did they go?
They're all overseas now, working in nuclear power plants all over the world. That's the story. All because government was afraid to have to make use of this. They were threatened. They said, "Oh, nuclear power plant, etc." But even when they did that, my uncle was saying, after they did that, they didn't have any alternative to create new power, new sources of power. So that's why, by the end of the Korean government, power went down. So we tend to think very short term. That's why my point is, we really need to think long term. And many of the problems we face now will not be solved overnight. Profit, many of these things will not. That's my answer. But I fully agree. A lot of soft things, soft skills that we need to brush up on. But they're there. It's just making sure that we know how to leverage them and try to have good people to start thinking of ways to support. Because I still really think that we can do much better. And I think all of you realize that too. We could, but we don't.